We're at the Veterans Coming Home Center, a division of the New Life Evangelistic Center in Springfield, Missouri, where the homeless are having an opportunity to utilize the computers. They get to do laundry, they get to meals, a place to take a nap, library, storage, and much, much more. Don't miss the program. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. So many people find themselves without a home, ending up at the New Life Evangelistic Center at 806 North Jefferson. Tell us your name.
I'm Carol Lansdowne.
I hear that often they call you Grandma. Is that correct?
Yeah.
They do. Is this all your belongings right here?
Right now, I've got some stored away.
How important is this place to you right here?
This is a real good place for vets, even homeless people to come. They have a free clothing room. Mm-hmm. They have food. And Sundays, well, Saturday morning, they have light breakfast. And Sundays, they have lunch. They always have good meals. There's a lot of fellowship here. There's a lot more that could be done. Like, there's some people that really need a lot of help, support, moral, mentally.
And you are?
Physically.
Well, you found yourself homeless. Who's this guy back behind you with the mask?
That's my husband.
That's your husband?
James Lansdowne. I'm a service-connected Vietnam veteran.
You're a veteran yourself. What happened to your arm?
I got pins all over it and even in my brain.
Wow. So you and your wife are homeless right now?
Yeah. We're going to get an apartment Friday.
And how important is this place to you right here?
Very important. It concerns us all.
So you're a Vietnam War veteran?
Yes.
And you and your wife found yourself without a place at all?
Yes.
And you're here?
Because of my checks at the bank.
What happened there?
They didn't want to. State First National didn't want to do their job. They hired new people out there. And I had to transfer them to Northtown Mall at Albany Bank.
They basically sent them back. And then when we went to get the money wasn't there. Then we had to work around for a few months to get it all lined up. And they've done a lot of help here with us, Joe and all the boys, what they can do. And then we went through home at last.
Wow. And so, and then you come here.
We have meals. I can do my laundry here. Mm-hmm. He goes to Victory Mission. He does his laundry there. Right now, at present, I do my laundry here. I can take a shower here. I'm staying safe to sleep myself. If I need a shower, I can take one here.
And then your meals and the other.
And my meals is here.
You know, we really had to fight to just get this place open.
I know it.
We had to go against the city.
I know.
The county. The school. And this is federal surplus property.
I know.
It used to be a Social Security building, one big battle after another, but praise God, we're here.
He's here, and he needs to stay open.
Amen.
I got a Purple Heart from Vietnam and also an honorable discharge.
You did. Wow.
And I got a star behind that Purple Heart beside it.
And they're homeless here, and that's
why
we're
trying to help
them.
It really is vitally important. There's veterans like my husband, Joe, different ones here that served the country, and they're getting kicked out of places. And it's vitally important.
Chester and all of them have been very good to us.
Well, we thank God for the people that donate to keep the place open, don't we?
I do, too.
We certainly
and
thank.
And I thank Joe and Chester.
Yeah, so we thank God for all of you that are a part of what God is doing at this hour. And I'm just asking, just let the Holy Spirit work through you right now, because there's so many people that are hurting and homeless. And we ask you to pray for us now and share your much-needed gift with the New Life Evangelistic Center so we can keep this facility open at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield and the other outreaches of New Life Evangelistic Center. This facility is helping so many people.
My name's Tommy, and the center's been really good to me. They make sure I have food to eat and a place to come during the day. If I need to catch a few hours sleep, or if I'm in between job interviews and just need a place to sit down and rap with good people, there's good people here, you know, and they do a lot for us here in Springfield. I feel like God has touched my life in so many ways, more than I can count, but I can say that Springfield's a good town, and everybody here is really sweet, and I feel like God's been so good to me in so many ways that I can't even count. I'm glad to be alive. I'm glad to be here. And thank y'all for helping me.
What is your name?
Ryan.
Ryan, how do you like this Veterans Coming Home Center?
I like it.
Are you homeless right now?
Yes.
How'd you end up homeless?
My mom kicked me out over the girl I'm with.
Oh, so you got kicked out?
Yeah.
Wow. Well, while you're here, we not only want you to be able to utilize the many services that are here,
yeah,
But to know that God loves you. Do you ever stop and think about that?
Yeah.
Because life can really be tough without him.
Yeah.
Really. So here, you're utilizing the computers. We also have meals here and then showers here, place to nap here.
Yeah.
A lot of different things. We thank God for those that are praying and for the multitude of people that are getting help because of those of you that are caring and sharing. So many of the homeless and hurting come in here and they take a nap during the day. They've been up all night long, walking from place to place, nowhere to go. And they come to the New Life Evangelistic Center and they rest during the days here. All because of those that are sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center, making such a big difference in the lives of hurting and homeless people. I'm asking you to pray for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Let that God's light and love flow through you. A refuge for the hurting in their time of need. A refuge for the homeless because of all of you that are praying, caring, and sharing. You're holding a cane. Are you blind?
Yes, sir. I am. I have actually no vision in my left eye whatsoever and tunnel vision in my right.
How important is this center here, the New Life Evangelistic Center at 806 North Jefferson?
It is actually. I like it a whole lot. Mm-hmm. I mean, all these people, especially that gentleman right there, is very nice.
So you're talking about Chester and,
yes,
and Joe and the staff around here. They've been helping you a lot.
Yes,
they have.
What kind
of help do you get here?
Well, say if I need help carrying my food to the table.
So you get fed here, and then they'll help you get your food to the table and different services. So
yes.
Where would you be if this place was not open?
Honestly,
they don't want you hanging around the library. They don't want you here, there, and everywhere. And
no.
Hundreds of people come through this facility.
It is very, very, very nice they have places like this.
And we need you to help keep it open. New Life Evangelistic Center receives no United Way funding, no city, state, or federal dollars. It's caring people, letting God's light and love flow through them that make it possible for us to help the handicapped, the elderly, sick, blind, anyone that finds themselves homeless. It's the largest daytime walk-in facility in southwestern Missouri and northwestern Arkansas. Frequently referred to as the Veterans Coming Home Center because, yes, we make a special outreach to veterans, but people from all different walks of life are helped here that find themselves homeless at 806 North Jefferson. And your gifts are very important, and that's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. How I thank God for those of you that are caring and sharing at this critical hour. What a big difference for good you're making the lives of so many hurting and homeless people.
I volunteer at the Evangelistic Center in Joplin. If you we need volunteers too. We need donations of all kinds, and it's a lot of fun here.
My name is Connie Sue Wright, and my late husband was a veteran, and I live in a homeless shelter right now, but we have to leave because they have their schools starting, their church school starting. So everybody has to get up and get everything done and get out to wait to catch the van that brings us over here. And the veterans, just their blessings. They'll help me when I can't walk very good. I'm blind in one eye and have a really bad sense of balance. And they let me sit here where it's dry or cool, whichever way it is. And they feed me and help me do everything I need to do. And I really believe that Jesus slips blessings into your life. And you don't know it was a blessing until after it's over and you realize that it just, oh, wow, that was great. Thank you, God.
How you doing? My name is Edward. And God came to me and told me that I need to get my life together. So I came here and got my life together. And here I am. Got my life together. Thank God for that.
This is Steve here in Joplin Free Store, and I appreciate all my volunteers. I've got a good crew, and this place would not go without the crew. And it's nice to fellowship with them, find out what's going on in their lives, talk to them, and just have a good working atmosphere.
Hi, my name's Kenny. I'm a Christian. I've been saved and filled with the Holy Ghost. And God blesses me every day. I'm homeless right now. I'm getting ready to get an apartment today. And I thank the Lord for that. Amen.
My name is John. I've been coming here for 2 years. And it's right outside, so it's really nice being here and dry. I get a pair of clean socks. The Lord's been in my life since probably 9. 12, 16, 24. He comes and goes, probably like me. I'd like to thank the center for everything. Thank you.
My name's Becky. The Vet Center has really been a godsend to me since I've been here in Missouri. I've only been in Missouri for like 2 weeks, so, and they provide lunches and a safe, warm place to be in the bad weather. Clothing, they've helped me with my clothing for work, and bus tickets. They've really been a blessing to the community in more ways than one. I mean, they treat you with dignity and respect.
I'm Brother Bill Bates at the New Life Evangelistic Center, and I just came in off the street, and it's pouring down rain in Springfield, and the center allows me a place to get in off the street. Was soaking wet, and I'm allowed to use the laundry here, put my clothes in to get them done, and I just want to encourage everybody to support New Life Evangelistic Center in Springfield. We had a really good fellowship yesterday, and all the people that feed us showed up. We had our annual end gathering, so to speak, of people eating, and I just want everybody to pray for Larry Rice Ministries and be supportive of it, because they're really helping a lot of poor people, and God bless you.
My name's Rick Fox. They help me here. I eat here. I sleep here. Joe helps me. Chester helps me. Eric helps me. You know, I help out. I don't cause trouble. You know, I get clothes. I eat, take my shower, get coffee. You know, I eat here. I help out. Don't cause trouble. You know, they're good people. You know, I get my clothes, and I love it here. And I don't want to get kicked out. And Chester and Joe love me. John loves me. You know, I do my thing, and I do not cause trouble. I run them off, they do. I don't want nobody bothering them. And I'm going to stay here if I can.
My name is Bob Sebelfield, and I was homeless on the street, living in my truck for a while. And this place has given me a place to eat. Yes, and I have everything I need except food and shelter. And also clothes. I lost all my clothes.
A lot of married couples find themselves coming in here. You are married?
Yes.
And to the man that I talked to earlier that was blind?
Yes.
And you found yourself homeless?
Yes.
Wow, that must have been pretty traumatic, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's pretty hard.
And then I just earlier talked to another married couple, elderly couple, a lot of married couples, it seems like, that are out here.
Yeah.
How important is this facility at 806 North Jefferson to you and your husband?
It's very important. It's really hot outside. You know, we're able to come in and take showers and wash clothes, mm-hmm. get out of the heat, cool off.
And his being legally blind, that makes it difficult?
Yes, it
Where
is.
Where would you all be if it had this place wasn't open?
We'd probably be sitting out in the hot street.
Wow. And then police tell you to move on, looks like.
Yeah.
So you have the responsibility of your wife and trying to meet the need yourself here, but this has been a big help to you.
Yes, sir, but my eyesight's not the only problem I have. Thank God they really, really do have places like this, because I was also born with open heart and lung surgery, and I appreciate these people a lot.
How long y'all been married?
Last Monday made 1 year.
Wow, 1 year.
We've been together for 4 years.
Uh-huh. So here you are, and things coming together for y'all?
Yes. We finally got everything together for housing.
So this has been a help to you to actually break the cycle of homelessness and get off the streets. Well, we certainly thank God for the people that are donating to the New Life Evangelistic Center. Your labor of love, your involvement right now is very, very important. Tremendous needs we're facing during this summer months here. And I'm asking, just please believe God with us for $500,000 miracle. He's a miracle-working God. The needs are mounting. There's more and more urgent crisis cases, not only throughout St. Louis and the bi-state area, but here in southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas, coming to our facility 806 North Jefferson. And I thank God for those of you that are caring and sharing at this critical hour. What a blessing you are in the lives of so many hurting and homeless people.
My name is Amber Roberson. I've been homeless for about 4 or 5 years now. The vet center has been really good to me. They're really good people. They'll help you with sleeping bags, tents, food. There's a good atmosphere up here. If there's anything that anybody can do to help with, like, donations, that would be excellent. And God's been a big part of my life. He's helped me through all this. So I just let go and let God.
Hi, my name is Celia. I'm having to volunteer at New Life Evangelist Center. I have volunteered for a whole year. God has brought me to this ministry, having to help the homeless and having the unfortunately. There's another name for that, unfortunately. We just come here having to volunteer and help out in free clothing for we need for people that come to bring free clothing and also food to this ministry. I have enjoyed having to do this ministry and continuing having to work for the Lord.
My name's Kevin Vigneault. I've been traveling all over the country trying to make this place beautiful for all of us. And all these people across the country have helped me so much. They've given me food when I needed it, given me clothes when I need it. Help me out any way possible, any way I need it. Because when you need something, it really should be there for you. And then sometimes you get what you want. I found this place basically traveling across my country to every church and mission. But today I was told by another homeless person that was sitting under staying dry, and he said to come down here for lunch. And that's how I'm here. And they've definitely touched me so far. Help me as much as they can, and I'm going to pass that on to everyone else along the way.
My name is Jeff, and I've been to the VA for about 4 years, and I enjoyed it. I got friends here to talk to me. I got friends out on the streets I talk to, and I appreciate the help. They helped me around here at the VA, because if it wasn't for them, I'd be on the streets right now. And if it wasn't for Jerry Rice, he would be a friend. I got to meet his son. His son is great. And he did a lot of things for me the last 2 weeks. And he's helped me out, talk to people right, without getting mad, getting temporized. And I enjoyed the whole staff here. And Big Joe, he's my buddy. I appreciate all of them. Thank you.
I love coming up here when it's really cold. I was homeless a couple years and didn't have a place to stay warm, and they fed me. I really appreciate what the people here at Larry Rice's have done for me. It's brought me a little bit of friendship and a place to get in out of the cold or when it's really hot to come in. Since then, my life's gotten better. It's though God's been looking after me, I got me a little part-time job and a place to live and got off the street. So for about 3 years, I really didn't have a place to call home. People I was living with kind of didn't really want to take me in, so I had trouble there, but I survived it through God's mercy and love. And I think we're just better off that there is a homeless shelter here where people care about us. And I'm really grateful for all of it. Thank you.
I'm here talking to one of our long-term volunteers. If you're a regular viewer, you know this man's name, but I'm going to let him tell you anyway.
Edward Cadott.
And Edward is here. How often are you down here volunteering?
Three, four times a week.
Yes, you are. And his wife, Virginia, recently went to be with Jesus. She cooks so many a meal. The New Life Evangelistic Center and its work among the homeless here in Springfield. She's gone to be with Jesus, but her husband's right here on the front lines, volunteering, helping out. Ed, why do you do this?
Well, it's needed. People need help, and that's what we're here for, is to help them.
Well, I know you're right here at the front desk. You're one of the first people that they see when they come in here. A lot of different people here. We're seeing more married couples that come in. We're seeing women. We're seeing veterans come. We're seeing a lot of hurting people come through these doors here at 806 North Jefferson, don't they?
Yes. And there's children that come in.
A lot of children, too. A lot of homeless people come in. You know, it's a miracle. We have this facility here because every week it seems like there's so many that come through and here. It's the largest daytime facility, southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas. We also have a residential facility for our homeless veterans, our trainees, and then volunteers from the community like Ed Cadott here are so very much needed. And I know your wife, Virginia, is just praising the Lord and in heaven right now, along with Penny. And you know, we're still here, and we got a job to do, don't we?
Yes, we do.
We got to do it. And you're still here, and we need you right now. Maybe you can't volunteer as frequently as Ed does, but what you can do is partner with us by being a prayer partner. We need prayer a big way here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And you can also partner with us by sharing your much-needed gift. You can get involved as a Club 24 member. It's only 80 cents a day, $24 a month. There's the Holy Spirit speaking to your heart now. Share a gift of $100. Or what about that $500 gift? Maybe sharing with you to give. It's urgently needed. Whatever the amount, please send it now to the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. So many people come to the New Life Evangelistic Center, not only throughout the bi-state area and the greater St. Louis area, but also in Springfield, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. So many people getting help because of those of you that are praying, caring, and sharing.
My name is Adrian. The center's helped me out a lot. It's kept me from going back to my old ways, old habits, old things that kept me down, that put me in this situation. God has touched my life in a way because for a couple years I was in a very, very dark path, and I had a very close call. And I had a wake-up call, basically, and I just had to turn my life around regardless of whatever it costs.
My name's Nicole Martinson, and the VA helps me out all the time. They help me out with bus passes and clothes when I need it. They give me lunch in the afternoons and breakfast in the morning, and yeah.
How has God touched your life?
What?
How has God touched your life?
He's given me my fiance. He's given me a place to stay. Everything. I owe everything.
God has touched my heart a whole lot. He led me to places that I ain't never been. One thing about it. All you gotta do is ask God. And the ABC, admit, believe, and confess to all your sins, and your life will be changed.
I have been coming here for almost 6 years, maybe more. And the center has helped me out. It's a good place to come to when you need to get off the street, if you're hungry, need some place to lodge, some place just to warm up on a winter day or cool off on a summer day. I feel this place has done a lot for a lot of people. And I really praise the staff 100%, along with the pastor of this facility. It has been a blessing to have a place like this in Springfield. For all those who need help, especially on the streets, who just need a helping hand in any way. It has touched my life as a person. I have met a lot of people since I've been here, and I think this is a great place to go. to meet new people, friendly smelling faces. And I feel that a person needs any help in any way, spiritually, physically, or mentally or emotionally, they should come here and get the help that they need to get back on their feet, because everybody is worth something. Everybody is worth the price. And I feel that this place could be a blessing to a lot of people if they would only just allow it to be. But there are so many people who just take advantage of the situation without really giving thanks and everything, no matter what. Difficult roads can lead to beautiful destinations. And a lot of people are on a difficult road, especially myself. And I know that if we just keep on pursuing our dreams and this path, we will get to a beautiful destination later on in life that we never even dreamed about before. This place could be a helping start. This place could be a blessing. And I feel that if those only reach out and come to the right sources, beautiful things are headed their way as a person. God bless.
Hi, I'm Eric. I'm basically Steve's cohort in crime down here in Joplin. We would do a lot of different things to make this free store free. We give away lots of clothes, lots of this, lots of that, and we accept donations like we believe. Without God's help, as well as everyone else's help, this place would not function to its 100% capabilities every day, except for Sunday, which is God's day of rest, as well as occasionally ours. We never know what we're going to get, and we're always on call, because sometimes donations come late at night, like a child, and we go out there and we find it the next morning, and we hope we get it before someone else takes it. So we really do appreciate everyone here in Joplin that has helped us out. The more the merrier. Have a great day, everybody.
Hi, James Chandler, and the Veterans Center has been a very good help to me. It's a place to come in and relax, get refreshing up, get some clothes, a good and blessed meal. I'm just so happy to have these type of places. We need more places like this in Springfield. And this is a really blessing from God, because I think, you know, these people are really trying to help people out and trying to get off the streets. And it's just a blessing to have places like this.
Tell us your name.
Amanda is my given name.
Amanda. Found yourself homeless, did you, Amanda?
About 3 years ago.
Wow. How has this place been helping you?
Immensely.
Has it really?
Yeah.
What's it been doing?
Everything you guys have to offer.
Is it? It's hard being a woman out on the streets, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Very hard. But the fellowship you get here, does that help build your... And then the
yes.
meals?
And yes. Good meals.
Free store. Mm-hmm. Storage.
I've never used the storage, but mm-hmm. it's there to be offered.
Mm-hmm. We're able to be there when people are hurting, whether it's the women out on the streets, the men, the homeless families, because of each and every one of you that are caring at this time, letting God's light and love flow through you. And I just want to say thank you. Thank you for being a part of the miracle that God is doing at this hour. Thank you for praying for New Life Evangelistic Center at this critical time when needs are so great. Oh, this has been one of the most difficult Augusts that we've experienced in recent history. I'm asking you to believe God with us for a $500,000 miracle. With Him, all things are possible. I thank God for those you've been praying, those you have been sharing. May God bless you in a very special way. We're just giving you an opportunity to be a part of a miracle at this hour. You can give through the PayPal system at the newlifeevangelisticcenter.org website, or send your much needed gift to P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Thank you for caring and sharing, making such a big difference in the lives of the hurting and homeless by praying for and getting involved in the work of the New Life Evangelistic Center.